My name is Jess. I work for the Conservatory of Recording Arts and Sciences. So I'm going to show you a trick called the 50 hertz tone, and that's to give a little bottom end to our kick drum, make it pretty fat down there, if you know what I'm talking about. And it really enhances kind of the volume and the thump of our kick. So here's how we can do this. First of all, I got this blank session here, and we got it set up just with a kick track. That is all we're going to be needing for today. So just a kick track, but really all we just need is just the audio to trigger some of the plugins that we have going on here momentarily. So we have our kick track, which is going, and yep, that is a kick drum with a lot of bleed. So go over here to our mix window, and we're going to create a new track. So what we're going to need to do is press the quick key for that, Shift Command N. So we have a new mono. What we want is an aux input track, though. So we're going to go ahead and change this to a mono aux input track. Since we're dealing with a kick track, mono will suffice just fine for us today. So since this is a 50 hertz tone trick, what we're going to need to do is get our signal generator. So we're going to go to plugin, other, and signal generator. So you can hear that beautiful sine wave. We're going to change that to 50 hertz. Ah, yes. And so we can definitely feel the rumbles in the tummy down there. So we got that. But this is going constantly, so what we're going to need to do is gate some of that signal out. So we're going to use that with some dynamics processing. So we're going to go back to our plugin, dynamics, and a couple plugins here. The two that we're going to be looking at is the Dyne 3 compressor limiter and Dyne 3 expander gate. Now these look almost identical. So if we look here at the compressor limiter, this does look like a compressor, essentially, but keep that in mind as we switch over to our other plugin. The expander gate looks almost identical except for the color on a few knobs. That's about the only difference visually, but how they actually operate is going to be a bit different here. So that's why we want to use the gate for this particular 50 hertz tone trick. So we have our kick here, we have our 50 hertz tone. Now we need to get the gate to actually cut in and out with the kick drum, so that way we don't just have a continuous sine wave going, because that's kind of boring and we don't want that. Boring is not interesting. So we're going to go to sidechain here, and this is going to be accepting our sidechain input. So if we turn that on, we can see that we have some gain reduction, and no longer do we have signal here. So it is effectively being gated out 100%. That is what we do want. But next, what we need to do is tell the gate to open when we want it to open. And in this case, we want it to open when the kick is hitting. So in order to make that happen, we need to set some sort of key input. So this was actually activating the key input, but we need to tell it what key input it's looking for to actually open the gate and let the signal go through. So we're going to need to choose our key input here. We can choose it from mic, interface, anything else, but we're going to use signal routing within Pro Tools. So we're going to go to bus, and since we don't have anything else, bus one will suffice just perfectly. Now what we need to do is send from our kick track. We need to create a send to trigger the key input over there on our gate. So since we already set bus one to be our key input there, we're going to accept bus one as our send here. And we can bring some of that level, that sweet, sweet level right there. So that's sending to bus one, which should be going to our key input there. And we are accepting the key input by turning that button on. And so now once we hit play, we should see signal going along with it. And there it is. Fantastic. So now we have a kick, and we have the 50 hertz tone to support it underneath and give it a little bit more boom in the bottom. Mm-hmm. And if you cut the send here, we can see that it's actually working. As we cut the send, now there's no longer anything triggering this gate to open, and thus no more big bottoms. So that's how you do the 50 hertz gate trick. Many other uses that you can use for it, so be creative, think about your signal routing and all the possibilities you can do there, and we'll catch you later.